the blue. Baby, maybe it's wrong, but baby, I hate you being gone. I got a book full of songs and an empty bottle, but really that don't mean jack. Cause unless you're here to hear how they go, how am I gonna get you back? I'm down on my knees with my hands in the air, begging for another shot. I'm asking you please, won't you show me you care? Cause baby, this is all I got. California, oh, she gets into your soul and won't let go. California, oh, I can't control her. She's coursing through my veins and I can't say no. I want to fall straight into your welcoming arms. I want to lay under your blanket of stars. California. If we drove all through the night, we could get to Vegas by morning. Let's leave this town behind, cause I could hear a lady not calling. If we drove and didn't stop, we could be in LA tomorrow. Leave the dust of the desert behind. Can you hear the call of the ocean? If we drove for the rest of our lives, we could see a million places, every inch of this beautiful land. Pale by the smile on your face, oh, don't need no mirrors, we ain't looking back. Come on and take me for a ride. I'm where I wanna be, I don't need no map. These feelings I just cannot hide.
Wednesday.
It is Wednesday. Skeggy's here. Skeggy asked how the physio was going.
Pretty good.
So, yeah, we actually saw the surgeon today for the 6-week checkup. It has been exactly 6 weeks since you were cut open, dug into,
sliced
and
diced.
You need to be closer to your mic, Hannah.
Sliced and diced.
Let's turn it up.
Okay. Remind me again which this one?
No. That.
That
turn
one.
It up to 12 o'clock.
Turn it up, turn it up, turn it up. Hey. Is it louder? I don't know. I can't tell. Hey. Hey.
There it is.
Hey.
That's probably better. So, yeah, went to the surgeon today for the six-week checkup.
And as you can see above me here,
one out of one doctors
state that Hamo is a star patient.
Yes.
That's 100%. Well, it's as close as I'm going to get. This is where it always is.
Yeah, so he was pretty pleased with the progress. So you see him again in another 6 weeks, right? And then that'll be it?
6 weeks, yeah.
Yeah. Right. So...
things are progressing nicely. I mean, it hurts right now because he was doing stuff, making me use my muscles and things.
He didn't make you do that much.
It was pushing quite hard.
Was he?
Oh, yeah.
Hmm.
Oh, yeah. It wasn't... Look, give me your arm. It wasn't like this.
Oh,
It was like that.
Yeah.
Push against that.
Yeah.
Keep push it out. Yeah. It was that hard.
Oh, wow. Well, no wonder you're star patient.
Yeah.
Mm. Yeah, so...
You don't pay any attention to
Well, I couldn't tell how hard he was pushing. How am I supposed to know? Yeah, the scar is healing nicely. So Hama's got three little...
I still haven't seen them.
Yeah, because you get ooked out by that stuff. It's basically three little crosses. They basically just made an X, and that was the hole.
I don't want to know. Just,
But yeah, it's all healing well.
Shit. Your blood and gore.
You get so skeevy with that stuff.
Yeah, because... shut up.
But yet you don't get skeeved, like, in a horror movie, when there's blood and gore.
Because horror movies are stupid.
Because
there's not blood and gore, it's just stupidity. I get irritated.
Yeah. All right. What are you going to play?
It's up on the screen. It's up on the list there. You could probably read it.
There's something wrong with your mic.
There's nothing wrong with my mic.
It is not picking up.
It's not picking up what?
It is really low. Really quiet.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. It is what it is. I mean, I could turn this up. But I figured that is where our problems were from before. Is that better?
Yeah, that is better. Yeah, once it gets to summer, yeah, washing and polishing the car will be good exercise for it.
I'm already doing that.
Yeah. Yeah, we washed the car, what, Friday? Saturday. Friday.
Friday?
Yeah, Friday, after we saw Alex.
And then we took it to Wantage.
Yes.
Oxfordshire.
Yeah, we'll talk about that in a bit. Thanks, Gaggy. Gaggy said that's lots better.
Well, I'd rather see a dead little girl. girl than to be with another man. You better keep your head, little girl, or you won't know where I am. You better run for your life if you can, little girl. Hide your head in the sand, little girl. Catch you with another man, that's the end, little girl. Well, you know that I'm a wicked guy, and I was born with a jealous mind. And I can spend my whole life trying to lead you to the line. You better run for your life if you can, little girl. Hide your head in the sand, little girl. Catch you with another man, that's the end, little girl. Baby, I'm determined that I'd rather you see you down. You better run for your life if you can, little girl. Hide your head in the sand, little girl. Catch you with another man, that's the end, little girl. Sam, little girl, catch you with another man, that's the end, little girl.
It's very cute that he called you the star patient.
See, now I feel like it's too much.
It's too much? I'll back it off of here.
Let's go in between. We got in between.
In between. Thanks, Skeggs. Skeggy
right
liked
right
it.
Right down the middle. Right down the middle.
Yeah, I was pleasantly impressed that he said, "You are a star patient." And you didn't even ask him for a treat.
I didn't even get a lollipop.
Yeah.
I wanted a red one.
I don't think they hand out lollipops anymore, dear. I think you're showing your age.
They hand them out in America.
They used to, yeah. I mean, like, recently used to. When we lived there.
My dentist had them. He had sugar-free ones.
Well, obviously, he'd have sugar-free ones.
And they were good.
Mm.
I always used to get a lollipop.
Wonder if they were. Wonder if you ate too many of them, if they'd be like the sugar-free gummy bears.
if you want to laugh your ass off, read some of the reviews on Amazon of sugar-free gummy bears, and people eating bags of sugar-free gummy bears in places like on airplanes, and the disasters that ensue. It is hilarious stuff.
If you just Google sugar-free gummy bear reviews, they're all over the place. Now, I'm sure half of them are made up. I don't even care anymore because it's just good writing.
It is. It's excellent. It's excellent writing.
Skeggy says you're lucky to even get in to see a doctor these days, never mind a lollipop.
Yeah, there is that.
Fair point, Liam. More lollipops, the more diabetes, the more money coming in. They just keep that revolving door going.
True.
Yeah, all the problems involved with sugar.
I haven't really started yet.
Oh.
I thought you were saying stuff.
I wasn't, but... Good. Good to see you serious. He's like, it's okay. I'm here. Shh. We'll be okay now. I imagine some patting going on. How you doing, Chief? How was everybody's weekends, by the way? Let us know.
So soon, just after you're gone, my sense is sharpened. That's too low. Hang on, I'm supposed to have my thingy on.
You forgot your capo.
I did.
Better now?
I'm better now. So soon, just after you're gone, my sense is sharpened. But it always takes so damn long before I feel how much my eyes have darkened. Fear hangs a plane of gun smoke drifting in our room. So easy to disturb with a thought, with a whisper, with a careless memory, with a careless memory. Oh, the table, the signs of love lie scattered, and the walls break, we go crashing within. It's not as though you really matter. But being close, how could I let you go without some feeling, some precious sympathy following? Fear hangs a plane of gun smoke drifting in our room. So easy to disturb with a thought, with a whisper, with a careless memory, with a careless memory, with a careless memory, with a careless memory, with a careless memory. I walk out into the sun, I try to find a new day, but the whole place, it just screams in my eyes. Where are you now? 'Cause I don't want to meet you. I think I die, I think I laugh at you, I know I cry. What am I supposed to do? Follow you outside. With a careless memory, with a careless memory, with a careless memory.
Zidius, thank you very, very much for your resub.
Resub.
35 months.
Resub. 35 months.
Yeah.
That's nearly 3 years.
Yeah.
Have I been doing this that long?
Yeah.
Fuck.
Yeah. And Sparkles here.
Well, fuck.
Good to see you, Sparkles.
Sparkle boobs. Sparkle boobs. Oh, how your boobs are so sparkly.
What did we get up to this weekend? We watched the race.
We went to Williams.
We went to Williams. If you follow Hammo on Instagram or Facebook, you will have seen some of the photos. It was cool. I enjoyed it. They did not do well in the race, but, you know. Madam X, good to see you, and thank you for your resub as well. Oh, that's right. Sparkle went to Hearn Bay. Your osteo visit was brilliant. That's excellent.
What is in Hearn Bay? That's by Margate. Margate.
I don't know.
Hearn Bay. By Margate. Ramsgate, Margate area.
Yeah.
It's just up the street, innit?
In it. Sparkle said, thank you for the lovely vocals, Hammo. It's good to see you all.
Did anybody else do anything exciting?
You're looking at a few properties in Hearn Bay, are you? You're looking to relocate permanently or getting a secondary weekend special event home or something? Hey, Kel!
She's got a... Miss Gail Taylor. Miss Gail Taylor. Miss Gail Taylor. Miss Gail Taylor. Miss Gail Taylor.
I just had a flashback to Plink.
Yeah, I did as well. As I was doing that.
So, that's Plink. It is Hammo's own song. It is different every time he plays it. And he used to just sit on the sofa and all of a sudden grab the guitar and start playing Plink. And I'm like, what in the name of all things are you doing? Hammo, hang on, Liam. Hammo has streamed on 327 days and for 847 hours. You spent 847 hours of your life doing this. And y'all have spent 847 hours watching this ridiculousness. Thank you.
That is...
We cannot...
I don't know if that's fun,
I don't know.
Cool, or depressing.
Thank you very much for indulging us for 847 hours on 327 days. That is...
Well, it'll be 850 hours by the end of
something.
The night.
Yeah.
What was I saying before?
What, Plink?
No, before that.
Something. I don't know. You sang the Miss Kel Taylor song.
Before that. Right before that.
You were getting ready to play the song. Aw, thanks, Skag. Oh, and Hammo went to open mic last night at the Ship.
At the Ship. And there's another one tomorrow night.
At the Gymnastry, yes. Yes.
I remember what it is. Buying a house in Hearn Bay because she needs somewhere to store that drum kit. Standing firm on this stony ground, the wind blows hard, pulls these clothes around. I harbor all the same worries as most. Temptations to leave or to give up the ghost. I wrestle with an outlook on life that shifts between darkness and shadowy light. I struggle with words for fear that they'll hear, but Orpheus sleeps on his back, still led to the world. Sunlight falls, my wings open wide. There's a beauty here I cannot deny, and the the bottles that tumble and crash on the stairs. Just so many people I knew never cared. Down below on the wreck of the ship, a stronghold of pleasures I couldn't regret. But the baggage is swallowed up by the tide. Orpheus keeps to his promise and stays by my side. Tell me, I've still a lot to learn, I understand. These fires never stop. Tired of laughing, I will hear the promise of my Orpheus sing. Have stories to tell of the power struggles in heaven and hell. But we feel secure against such mighty dreams as Orpheus sings of the promise tomorrow may bring. Tell me, I've still a lot to learn, I understand. These fires never stop, believe me. When this joke is tired of laughing, I of my Orpheus sing.
I love that tune. I love that tune. It's a cracking song. So, anybody get up to anything?
No, apparently the weather was counterproductive.
Was it?
Yeah, it was. It rained all weekend.
It didn't rain when we were at.
Well, it didn't rain while we were at Williams. I thought it rained on the way home because we were complaining about you washed the car and now it's raining.
No. That was because we were driving through puddles from where it had rained previously on previous days.
I see.
And the flooded street that we had.
We had to go on a diversion. Past the flooded street.
And it didn't really go past the flooded street. It just landed us right in the middle of the flooded street.
Yeah.
Which, you know, was shit.
Yeah. So years ago, the winter was so harsh, the sea froze at Herne Bay. Locals took their families out on the ice. Pictures of elderly in their chairs wheeled to the edge. Bless y'all. Bless y'all.
That is so stupid. Because if that gives way, that's like a lot of dead people.
Well, if they're only on the edge, it's not bad.
On the edge, even on the edge,
if you Living go in on the edge,
if you go in, you've got seconds.
I know. You forget where I grew up.
Oh, I know where you grew up.
I mean, that was the whole thing: waiting for the ice to be thick enough to go out there and do stupid shit, like drive on it. Awesome. Go ice skating on it. make a sled run, land on it.
I feel like that. Now that I've played Plink. Something else.
Yeah, see, you played Plink and you screwed it all up. Who knows what the Edge was doing there? Thinking up a
what
new baseline?
What is going on with this?
Proper Frozen Solid. It's
there
awesome. He thought if he built a pier, the steamers from London would use it. The pier was so long, he thought, to provide a carriage to transport from pierhead to town. Huh. That is very clever.
What is that?
The pier in... So that's the pier in Herne Bay?
It's like the one in Southend.
I guess.
Well, it's got a little train on it.
Yeah, it must be. I don't know. I've never seen it, so... Must be the same. So, like one of those little teeny trains, like the
yep.
Dymchurch. That thing looks like a train that you put your toddlers on, you know, at an amusement park. It's like, oh, no, this is an actual train, and people ride it, you know, to go from one to the other, not just as a novelty. Like, what the hell? You stuck a sail on it. That's genius. Here, good to see you, Roy. How you been?
Roy.
I kind of thought that we might have seen Roy last night, but he wasn't there.
No, he wasn't there.
No.
Ooh.
We're talking about gulls.
Hmm?
So.
What, like own gulls?
No. Gull.
Gull?
Yeah, gull. As in
seagull.
Exactly.
I mean gulls.
Yeah, gulls, and how they are the worst. Because the comment was made, you know, there's nothing like fish and chips right by the seaside and blah, blah, blah. It's like, yeah, except for the damn birds. They're just bastards. apparently the gulls at Herne Bay are not as bad as they are in Cornwall and other places. Where were we? Hastings. They were pretty... Was it Hastings?
Yes, it was Hastings.
Is that where Sean was yelling at the one?
Hastings or Brighton? When we were... are you talking about the time when they were trying to eat my chips?
No, I was talking about the time where there was one up on the roof and...
Oh, that was Hastings.
Yeah, and Sean was having a conversation with it, telling it to do one. Because it was just standing there shouting and, like, staring at us. It's like, what the hell? Yeah, see? Sparkle had to hide her ice cream cone from four giant lurking seagulls. Exactly. Cornish gulls are bad. It's the accent. Oh, God, yeah. All your roads are shut, Roy, in Edenbridge and surrounding. Yeah.
All the roads are shut.
Yeah, there's loads of diversions and... It's the time of year, so they have to use their road budget by, I'm guessing, they had to have it spent or allocated by the end of March. So that's why all these roadworks are still going on, because they had to hurry up and spend all their money.
That's no excuse. Knocking on my front door, same old line you used to use before. And I said, yeah, well, what am I supposed to do? I didn't know what I was getting into. So you've had a little trouble in town, now you're keeping some demons down. Stop dragging my heart around. Ooh. Ooh. It's hard to think about what you've wanted. It's hard to think about what you'd lost. This doesn't have to be the big get even. This doesn't have to be anything at all. I know you really wanna tell me goodbye. I know you really wanna be your own girl. Baby, you could never look me in the eye. Yeah, you buckle with the weight of the world. Stop dragging my heart around. Some bright-eyed kid. You need someone looking after you. I know you really wanna tell me goodbye. I know you really wanna be your own girl. Baby, you could never look me in the eye. Yeah, you buckle with the weight of the world. Stop dragging my heart around. Ooh. Stop dragging my heart around.
stop dragging my heart around. Stop dragging my heart around. Stop dragging my heart.
Skeggy said that was a nice version.
Thanks. Thanks, Skeggy.
I enjoyed that as well. We're still talking about seagulls and how they're bastards.
Rockin' and a rollin'. Down to the beach I'm strolling. Seagulls poke up my head. I say, seagulls, stop it now.
No. Ooh, ah, ooh, 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 ah.
Oh, yeah, that one.
The other one was, whatever it was, the 5, 6, 7, 8s.
It's pretty much the same song.
Yeah, well. Yeah, there are the words. I don't know what seagulls in this country eat, but dear God, I mean... There are places in our parking lot where we don't park.
Unless we absolutely have to.
And we don't want to leave the car there for any of... Hey, Big Socks. I knew I had that one, right? Thank you. Because it dries like concrete. Even with the pressure washer, it doesn't come off. It's just messed up. Big Socks, you're out of the land of cheese now, obviously, and back in the desert. How was the cheese trip? Was there much lion dancing and things to behold? I asked him how the weather was, and he said it was like in the 30s and 40s, so colder than it is here. I'm like, no, that's a no. We are very similar in most ways, except for that. He prefers the cold, and I just do not want. Yes, the only thing Wisconsin does have going for it, Madam X, is that it is, you know, pretty much, well, in America, it's cheese mecca. There's a lot of better cheese out there than Wisconsin cheese, but it's... We let them have it because it's pretty much all they have. So.
Just having a little practice while you're talking about cheese. And your brother going back to the homeland.
Sirius says, you have to use a seagull to scrub the bird turd from the car. It isn't any better than a cloth, but you feel better for screwing with one of them. I like it. No, there's some... Yeah, it's not the processed sliced American cheese that you get in Wisconsin. It's like actual cheese, but I wouldn't
you
call it...
You mean like yellow cheese?
Yeah.
Or orange cheese?
Yeah. Yeah, so it's not the pre-made, you know, rubbery... floppy stuff that makes a very good grilled cheese sandwich, but is not good for any other thing.
Burger.
Yeah. It's not that, but...
It's like a poor relation of cheddar.
Yeah, it's a really
They're
poor relation
extra
of
strong.
Cheddar.
They're extra strong.
Oh, God, no.
Cheese.
Not blue cheese. No.
Because it's just called cheese.
Yeah.
It's extra strong cheese is equivalent to a half mild.
Yeah.
Which is weird, because Americans like their food flavorful and spicy.
And yet, not in the Midwest, but yes.
Well, they like it. They like it flavorful. They always complain about how boring English food is.
I know.
It tastes like what it's supposed to.
I know.
Because it's not seasoned and got sauce and shit all over it.
Yeah. No, they don't make any blue cheese, as far as I'm aware, in Wisconsin. They might. I don't think so. I don't think they allow any
they
sort of...
They do have a castle made of cheese.
Yes. Roy, that is sad. Roy had to say goodbye to his faithful 25-year-old Astra, or he's g- going to say goodbye to it in July because the rust has gotten to it and it won't pass another MOT.
Do not buy an electric car.
Yeah.
Hydrogen is coming.
Yeah, it's definitely not worth a journey for weak cheddar. Save your money, go to France. Get, you know, French cheese.
Happy days, they seem so hard to find. I try to reach for you, but you have closed your mind. Whatever happened to our love? I wish I understood. It used to be so nice, it used to be so good. So when you need me, darling, can't you hear me, SOS? The love you gave me, nothing else can save me, SOS. When you're gone, how can I even try to go on? When you're gone, though I try, how can I carry on? Seems so far away, though you are standing near. You make me feel alive, but something died, I fear. I really tried to make it up. I wish I understood. What happened to our love? It used to be so good. So when you need me, darling, can't you hear me, SOS? The love you gave me, nothing less can save me, SOS. When you're gone, how can I even try to go on? When you're gone, though I've tried, how can I carry on?
So, as is our wont, we are on to the food discussion and all things cheese. Apparently, they do make a blue cheese in Wisconsin, by the way. I bet it's terrible, but maybe not. I will have to try it. But we were talking about the very fine cheeses produced here in Britain. Lovely Stilton. A nice bit of cheddar. You also like a Cheshire. Because it's like a Wensleydale, but less crumbly. But I also like a Wensleydale. So Skeggy has asked. yes, some warm baguette. Skeggy has asked, okay, on toast, do you do red cheese or white cheese? And I'm like, just do both cheeses. All the cheese.
Red cheese or white cheese?
So Sparkle said she, if she's doing cheese on toast, it's just whatever cheese she has open at the time.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter.
Blue cheese, runny French cheese, don't care.
All the cheese.
Put it on the toast. Grill it. Put it on the bread. Grill it. Make it toast. Can I have the blood run, please?
Sure. So, Zerius is fond of Dairy Lee.
It's on here. I like
Dairy
Lee.
Baby Bell is a tad too mature. So it's fair. So is that an actual thing? Like you have very differing cheese
Mrs.
strength
X.
opinions?
Mr. X is a cheese wimp.
The sample you had at the farmer's market was pretty good. Didn't get any because, yeah, soft cheeses definitely don't travel well. A cheese wimp, you say? Oh, my. Goodness me. Yeah. I mean, trust me, I got nothing against a Baby Bell.
I'm happy about that information being out there.
I got nothing against a Baby Bell. They're tasty. Oh, my God.
You know what? I don't have anything against a Baby Bell. And I would like to. I'd like my tongue to be against a Baby Bell.
But that is another T-shirt right there. But if I'm going to have cheese and not just, you know, shove something in my face, I want actual proper cheese. You know, I want a Brie. I want a Stilton. I want an Edam. You know, I want all of those things. I was scrolling through Instagram and I stopped and showed you this because it was one of those Stitch ones, you know, where it's a reaction to the video. And so this girl, I forget what she was talking about, and she opens up this Baby Bell that is as big as her head.
Oh my God, yes.
And the guy commenting on it, he's like, stop, I don't want to talk anymore. Where did you get that Baby Bell? No, it's not a Baby Bell. That's a Mama Bell. Where did you get that big Mama Bell or whatever? I forget what he called it, but I was like, it was, I'm not even joking, y'all. It was as big as her head. And so I started Googling it.
It was like this size.
It was
big. It's a lot of cheese. It's probably a good pound of cheese.
And apparently they used to have it at like Tesco and Sainsbury's and whatever, and they don't carry it anymore. So it might just be a special, I don't know, thing. But yeah, it was huge. I wanted it.
I mean, all it is
I don't care.
Mini Dutch cheese.
It was gigantic.
Edam, sort of.
Edam's fine.
I like Edam.
I liked it because it was big. Just want a big old Baby Bell that I can shove my whole face into and still have Baby Bell coming out the side of my head.
I could shove a lot of small Baby Bells in your face.
You could. I wonder how many Baby Bells I could fit in my mouth at one time.
Out and touch faith. Your own personal Jesus. Someone to hear your prayers. Someone who cares. Your own personal Jesus. Someone to hear your prayers, someone who cares. Feeling unknown when you're all alone, flesh and bone by the telephone. Lift up the receiver, I'll make you a believer.
take second best, put me to the test. Things on my chest, I need to confess. Oh, I will deliver, you know I'm a forgiver. Reach out and touch for ease. Reach out and touch for ease. Someone to hear your prayers, someone who cares. Your own personal Jesus. Someone to hear your prayers, someone who cares. Feeling unknown when you're all alone, flesh and bone by the telephone. Lift up the receiver, I'll make you a believer. Take second best, put me to the test. Things on my chest, I need to confess. Oh, I will deliver, you know I'm a forgiver. Reach out and touch for ease. 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 Touch faith.
All right. Now it's getting interesting, y'all.
What?
We've moved on to ice cream. Favorite ice cream flavor?
Vanilla.
Yes. Because you can put all sorts of stuff on it if
but
you
it
want.
But it is not in that. That is the flavor base for all ice cream.
Yeah. So both Skeggy and Roy... Rum raisin. Rum and raisin. And Zerius is agreeing with it. Mrs. X likes a mint chocolate chip. I like all of it. All of it. Bring it on. Chocolate, yep. Strawberry, yep. Mint chocolate chip, sure. Cherry Garcia, fuck yeah. Chunky Monkey, all of it. I don't care how artificial it's... Ooh, okay, the ice cream this afternoon was white chocolate, cherry, and pistachio with cherry ripple. Oh, yeah. I like cherry stuff. Out at the shop for a cone, most likely. I think that's the go-to here. Oh, and a... What do you call it here? A Mr. Whippy? Whatever it is, the stuff with the flake in it. The soft serve. Love that. Love it.
Soft serve.
Yeah, love it.
Mr. Whippy is the king of soft serves.
Yeah, love it. Brilliant. Second roll that thing in marshmallows.
I see. You just fucked it up.
Yeah, marshmallows. Tutti Frutti. Citrus ones. Love it. All of it.
Sitting here wasted and wounded at this old piano. trying hard to capture the moment. This morning I don't know. With a bottle of vodka still lodged in my head, if blonde gave me nightmares, I think she's still in my bed. As I dream about movies they won't make of me when I'm dead. With an ironclad fist I wake up and French kiss the morning, while some marching band keeps its own beat in my head while we're talking about all of the things that I long to believe, about love, the truth, what you mean to me, and the truth is, baby, you're all that I need. I wanna lay you down in a bed of roses. For tonight I sleep on a bed of nails. Oh, I wanna be just as close as the Holy Ghost is. Lay you down on a bed of roses. Well, I'm so far away, each step that I take's on my way home. A king's ransom in dimes I give each night to see through this payphone. Still I've run out of time, or it's hard to get through, till the bird on the wire flies me back to you. And I'll just close my eyes and whisper, baby, blind love is true. I wanna lay you down in a bed of roses. For tonight I sleep on a bed. Close as the Holy Ghost is, and lay you down on a bed of roses. Well, this hotel bar's hangovers, whiskey's gone dry, the barkeeper's wig's crooked, and she's giving me the eye. Well, I might have said, yeah, but I laugh so hard I think I'd die. About you, while my mistress she calls me to stand in a spotlight again. Tonight I won't be alone, but you know that don't mean I'm not lonely. I've got nothing to prove, 'cause it's you I would die to defend. I wanna lay bed of roses. For tonight I sleep on a bed of nails. Oh, I wanna be just as close as the Holy Ghost is, and lay tonight I sleep on a bed of nails.
That's all I wanna be, just as close as the Holy Ghost is. And lay you down on a bed of roses.
Yeah, I need to start walking around like Joey used to with a spoon. Because I don't
like a Coke spoon.
No, no, no. You can't. You're not going to get enough ice cream on a Coke spoon.
Oh,
it's going to be my
know.
Ice cream spoon.
You're thinking of a regular Coke spoon.
No. Oh, sorry. I wasn't thinking of a Keith Richards Coke spoon.
Yeah.
Flipping soup ladle. Good to see you, Orbiter. How you been? Morning. How's things?
How are things, my friend?
Zerius said, oh, nicely man. Played. Skeggy enjoyed that one as well.
Not played that in a while.
Yeah. We were talking about Moose Tracks ice cream, which we don't have over here. It is vanilla ice cream with...
Moose cock? Is it moose cock?
No, it is not. It is not, Oli. But it has peanut butter cups in it, and usually with either a caramel or a chocolate fudge swirl in it. So, yeah, I could destroy that in one sitting. One sitting. But again, I could power through a tub of most ice cream in one sitting. I don't have very many skills, but that is one of them. It's not a skill that's beneficial for anything.
Pretty bad resume.
But it is one that I have.
About keeping it real.
Nonetheless. Yeah.
Tubs of ice cream.
Yeah, tubs of ice cream. All about the tubs of ice cream. So yes, for those who weren't here at the beginning, we what we got up to over the ooh. You're putting around in the old VW bug.
Nice.
That's tasty. That is nice. Love that. It is beneficial for the dairy industry. Yeah, I'll give you that. Yeah, we went to the Williams Formula One Heritage, went on the Heritage Tour, so saw basically from the first one all the way through the modern. The six-wheel one was your favorite, wasn't it?
I love a six-wheel Formula One car.
It's absolutely bizarro, but great. So that was the highlight of the weekend. And then Hamo saw the surgeon today, as it is the six-week mark since he had a surgery. And the doc said that he was a star patient.
Use those exact words.
Yeah, so he's been full of himself ever since. I'm very pleased with your recovery.
If you're lucky, later tonight, you will be too.
Yeah. Would you look at that?
Come away with me in the night. Come away with me, and I will write you a song. Come away with me on a bus. Come away where they can't tempt us with their lies. I wanna walk with you on a cloudy day in fields where the yellow grass grows knee high. So won't you try to come. Come away with me and we'll kiss on a mountain top. Come away with me and I'll never stop loving you.
Lovely little
it
tune.
It is a lovely little tune. Yeah, I am. Fernando is my favorite. He is just. He's the best one. I mean, I didn't watch the interviews after, but I am certain that he was. Who did he have behind him? He had a Piastri behind him, didn't he? Mm. I'm certain that he was cat and mousing him to keep. Kept him in the DRS so he could just stay that much further ahead of George so he wouldn't have to deal with George. Because somebody said, one of the commentators said, do you really think Alonso thinks that far in advance or is that calculating? It's like, if anybody is that calculating on the grid, it is Fernando Alonso. He always. Oh, he has finally admitted it. Oh, that's awesome. It's so good.
Well,
he's finally. Mrs. X said, I think Alonso has finally admitted that he was dragging Oscar ahead. It's absolutely brilliant. I think he is aging backwards as well, too.
Yeah, he came into this season looking like 5 years younger than he did
yeah.
5 years ago.
Yeah. Well, you know, the fine art of not giving a crap anymore and just enjoying what you have is quite, you know, and I don't think he has children. And we've all proven that having children ages you. Serious, Alonso was actually thinking about the next race while helping Oscar. He is the Chuck Norris of Formula One.
He's a rebel and a runner. He's a signal turning green. He's a restless young romantic, wants to run the big machine. He's got a problem with his poisons, but you know he'll find a cure. He's cleaning up his systems to keep his nature pure. We'll be right back.
running to match the beat of the old world man. Learning to catch the heat of the third world man. He's got to make his own mistakes and learn to mend the mess he makes. He's old enough to know what's right and young enough not to choose it. He's noble enough to win the world, but weak enough to lose it. He's a new world man. He's a radio receiver in the factories and farms. He's a rider and a ranger and a young boy bearing arms. He's got a problem with his power, with weapons on patrol. He's got to walk a fine line and keep his self-control. Trying to match the day of the old world man. Trying to pave the way for the third world man. He's not concerned with yesterday. He knows constant change is here today. He's noble enough to know what's right, but enough not to choose it. He's wise enough to win the world, but fool enough to lose it. He's a new world man. Learning to match the beat. The heat of the third world man. He's a new world man. He's a new world man. He's a new world man. He's a new.
Big Socks, good to see you. Thanks for hanging out. Have a good rest of your day at work.
Go be a dragon. Go be a dragon, man. Be a dragon.
Go be a dragon.
Go be a dragon. Right. You know, take that day by storm. Go be a dragon.
So Madame X says, because I'm an old person these days, I've been researching mattresses today. Time for a new one and trying to decide whether to go with a newfangled hybrid one. So is that part memory foam, part wrapped spring, I guess? Is that what that is? Skaggy wants the F1 grid to be in reverse. So he wants all the top drivers and teams to go to the back of the grid.
I have some ideas about that.
We have a memory foam mattress, Madame X, which I quite like. I don't know if I would care for the springy things.
You know what? When we sleep on springy mattresses, we annoy each other.
Yes.
And it annoys us. When we stay in hotels and they have springy mattresses, I never get a good night's sleep.
That is true.
Because
it's
I
not
can feel
everybody.
You moving around.
That's the thing. So
the femory moment. Femory moam.
The femory moam.
The femory moam mattress.
Get yourself a femory moam mattress right here.
Right here, femory moam. Yeah, I can't feel you moving around.
Yeah. I mean, that is the whole
it's
point.
It's like you're dead, and I kind of like that.
It's all your dreams come true. Getting a good night's sleep. The wife isn't nagging.
There are times when I wake up and go, are you dead? I actually say that to you. You don't answer. So then I like poke you. Oh, she's breathing. All right.
Yeah, she breathes.
Because you lay there and like.
Well, my eyes wouldn't be open.
Sometimes they are.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Sometimes you lay there on your side staring at me, and I'm like, what's that?
Oh,
about?
That's got to be disturbing as hell.
It's odd.
That has to be frightening.
Sometimes I go.
I've seen myself.
And then I'll poke you. And you roll over.
Why are you just telling me this now after this many years?
It's never occurred to me.
Because obviously I don't know. So my eyes are open. Oh,
sometimes.
That has got to be creepy
sometimes,
as hell.
Sometimes you're laying there staring at me. Like.
So I used to sleepwalk and I would, you know, obviously. Basically, I would get up, go and sit on the couch and just stare off into space and freak my parents out, like, a lot. And then they'd kind of gently just guide me back into bed, and I'd go back to sleep. But yeah, no memory of it, no.
Well, you're still doing the scary thing.
I'm still scary.
You're just not getting up. You're just being your usual lazy self and not actually getting up.
Yeah, still scary after all these years.
Orbe coming in with Orbe claps.
Yeah, I'd be interested to see the reverse grid. But if you do a reverse grid, you cannot have blue flags.
Right. So, all right. You've got to get rid of blue flags altogether.
Oh, you did? Serious?
They are racing drivers. It doesn't matter that the guy's a back marker. He might be racing with somebody, maybe not immediately on the track with him, but he's racing for that position for the end of the race. And you, as the person who is destined to overtake, shouldn't interfere with his race.
Mm.
So you should pick your spot and make your overtake just like you do with every other competitor. Blue flags are bullshit.
Yeah.
Get rid of them. It's fake news is what it is. Fake news.
So, Orbiter, what a blue flag is that when the top runners are coming up behind a slower moving car, the back markers, as they're called,
when they're lapping the back markers.
So, fully overtaking.
The back markers get shown a blue flag.
And that means they have to move
within,
out of the way.
Within two or three flags, they have to move out of the racing line so that they don't hold up the front runners. It's crap. It's bullshit.
Yeah, it's like, if you're good enough, you can overtake.
The point is you're supposed to overtake. And if you can't overtake a back marker then, you know, and your race gets ruined, then guess what? Tough titties. Suck it.
Can you imagine that
in
NASCAR?
Now, NASCAR's not even racing.
I know,
it's
but
just going a,
but could you imagine
going
that
a donut.
In NASCAR, you know, if you're... I don't know. I don't know any of the new drivers, but if you're Dale Earnhardt and you're coming up on whoever, Ricky Bobby, and you know, you're gonna lap him by one lap. It's like, hey Ricky, you gotta move over. It's like, the hell I do. I mean, he either overtakes me or yeah, it is weird. It bothers us. Madam X wants to get rid of DRS.
All right, so DRS. I'm okay with DRS, but I think that you should only be allowed to use DRS once per complete lap, particularly on tracks where they have multiple DRS zones. So if the DRS zone is the, let's take Austria, because that's a good example, because you've got the main straightaway, then you've got the next long straightaway, then you've got another long straightaway, all of which can be DRS zones.
Right, let me quickly explain DRS for those who don't know. Basically, a little flap opens up in the back wing of the car.
Back wing goes like that to reduce downforce and drag so the car goes faster.
Yeah.
And then it reattaches when they hit the brakes. So as they come into the corner, it reattaches, giving them the downforce, which gives them the grip to go around the corner. So if you use your DRS on the main straight, you can't use it then again for an entire lap of running without DRS, which means that you can't use it on the main straight again. You have to wait until the second straight to use it, because you didn't finish using it until the end of the main straight. So you have to get to that point again before you can use your DRS again.
Xerius has got some good ideas. Social media voting for turning on or off DRS, but the driver isn't told. So if they get the most votes in social media, they get to turn on their DRS.
Tire allocations.
Hang on. There's one more DRS thing. Give everyone 90 seconds of DRS to be deployed whenever you want, but it comes off of your time at the end. So if you don't use your DRS for the entire race,
your time is as stands.
Your time is as stands. But for every second of DRS you use, it's
they
taken
add
off.
That back
yeah,
on.
Exactly. That's quite interesting.
Well,
I like that.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I don't know how much difference that would make.
What is the VAR in soccer? I don't know what the VAR
that's
where
they,
is.
That's the automatic review of scoring goals.
Oh, is it? They do not do that.
They do that in touchdowns.
Yeah.
In American football.
But
same
yes,
thing.
They don't have any sort of automatic review in Formula One, no.
They have the
virtual
stewards
referee.
Who are supposed to review things as it happens.
Don't even start the
but
stewards.
They don't get around to doing that until after the race. It's all bullshit.
Yeah.
Anyway. Tire allocations. I think that they should allocate. They have to use two compounds of tires. So there's a medium, there's a hard, a medium, and a soft tire for every race.
Yep.
There are actually five compounds, so they'll either bring the really, really soft one, the less soft one, and the medium one, and call the medium hard, middle soft.
Yeah,
don't
overcomplicate it.
But I think at the beginning they should only have three compounds. Forget the other two. Just have three compounds. And that every team must nominate which two compounds they're going to use for each race at the beginning of the year.
Before
and
the
that allocation
starts.
Doesn't get made public until the start of the race weekend.
Yeah.
So you have to decide, okay, we've got to use two compounds, but they've got to use each compound in equal measure. And if there's an odd number of races where it's then the last race or the last two races would be free for all.
Ooh, stir fry tonight.
That's what I
like the tire allocation idea. I think it's a good idea. We did stir fry the other night. I keep forgetting that I like doing stir fry. It's quick, it's easy, it's nice. I like
it. You totally forgot it when we only had one burner.
Yeah.
We were trying to heat things up in the oven and the steamer and doing all kinds of things. And then we got the new stovetop and we went, oh, let's make a stir fry.
Genius.
One pot.
Genius.
We're not smart people.
No, we are not smart people.
Sometimes.
Right.
Down. I
feel I'm tragic like I'm Marlon Brando when I look at my China girl. I could pretend nothing really meant too much when I look at my China girl. I stumble into town just like a sacred cow. Visions of swastikas in my head, plans for everyone. It's in the white of my eyes. My little China girl, you shouldn't mess with me. I'll give you eyes of blue. I'll give you a man who wants to rule the world. And when I get excited, my little China girl says, oh baby, just you shut your mouth. She says, shh.
Seeparina, good to see you.
Seeparina. Seeparina.
So I would be thrilled with that if Christian Horner was fired and replaced by Valtteri Bottas. That's a Red Bull I can get behind.
Yeah. Yeah. You make everybody have mallets.
Madam X thinks that Red Bull will try to get Sainz. I mean, I said it the other day. During the race, if you are a team and you are not looking at signs, you're missing the trick, because honestly he is exceptionally good. I think Checo's done after this year.
I read a thing today about Stroll. There's rumors that he wants to stop being a driver and stop being involved in the team management.
I don't know. It's hard to say.
He'd probably be a good, fairly good team manager.
Can't be any worse than anybody else. I bet he wouldn't be as bad as Christian Horner. So, you know, there's
that. He's not that much of a douche. I don't know anybody that is that much of a douche.
Yeah, well, I mean, yes, Lewis may be over the hill, but I'll say this about Ferrari. Ferrari kills careers. Ferrari hasn't had a successful driver since Michael Schumacher. Prove me wrong. They kill careers. They ruined Felipe Massa.
No. The spring to the head ruined Felipe Massa.
Well, okay.
Felipe Massa was good, but not the great driver that he was before he took the spring to the head.
They destroyed Vettel's career.
The thing about Ferrari is that it's a very intense... They demand a lot of their driver.
Mm.
They demand a lot of all their crew.
Yeah.
That's why when somebody's not performing, they're out. You know, look at how many team bosses they've had in the last 15 years.
Yeah.
Five?
I mean, I like Fred Vasseur.
Six?
I think he's a...
Domenicali.
Yep.
The other guy that I really liked after that.
No.
Gray hair.
Yeah.
Then there was the interim guy, then Bonotto.
Yeah, I liked Bonotto as well.
And now Fred Vasseur. That's five in 15 years.
Yeah. I like Vasseur a lot. I also liked Domenicali, though.
Yeah, I liked them all.
Yeah, they were all right.
It's a different thing.
Skeggy just said the name is bigger than any of the drivers, and they let the driver know that. It's like, we are Ferrari.
Well, the other thing is that most teams will build a car around their star lead driver.
Much like Red Bull with
And the
Max.
Other driver has to get along with that.
Yep.
And adapt their driving style to drive the car that's set up for their, not for them. Ferrari build the car that they think is the fastest, and then both drivers have to adapt their driving style to suit the car.
Kind of like McLaren as well, or at least how McLaren used to be.
Yes.
In the Ron Dennis.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because that's how it used to be. You used to be not able to have a car built to the driver's particular idiosyncrasies and strengths. That's why when they built this car, that Mercedes built this last car, having Russell as a second driver meant that they had to build a car that was long enough
for him to fit into it. Yeah.
Not that he couldn't fit into Lewis's car when he sat in for him in the one race in Sakhir.
It just wasn't as comfy as it could have been.
But, you know, I mean, that's... You drive a small, cramped car for a couple of hours and you get away with it, but you can't do that for a whole season. So they had to design the car, and that made the car... That changed the driver position for Lewis, where he didn't feel the car in the same way, and that's a large reason why he underperformed.
Yeah.
He said he wasn't in the right position in the car, and there's nothing they could do about it to put him in the right position of the car because of the way the car had to be designed to fit George in.
Yeah, definitely cheese and onion flavored crisps. Thank you, Seaparina. Tasty.
Oh yeah, I had cheese and onion flavored last night.
Seaparina is still sad about Günther Steiner, but I know why Günther is fired and why Haas doesn't win.
Oh, yeah, you do.
Yeah. I'm convinced of it. Nobody can convince me otherwise. Gene Haas has this team purposely to lose money. It is a tax write-off.
He wants the team to come in last.
Or... Not, you know, he doesn't want them to do any better than last, second to last, right down there at the bottom of the barrel. It is a tax write-off. It is a money loser for him.
Because he can write off all of that on his taxes.
Yep.
We've said it before.
Yes.
Because he went to jail for tax fraud.
He went to jail for tax evasion. 16 months or something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's for him it's a loophole. It's a loophole. It's a tax loophole.
Yep.
That he's spending as little.
Gene Haas did. Seeparina went to jail for it.
As little money as he can spend on the Formula One team is what he's spending.
Yeah, it's a loss leader.
That's why he either has young, inexperienced rookies in the car or older guys who are still trying to hang on to their career who would do much better in a different team.
Yeah, I'm convinced of it. Again, there's no proof. I'm not trying to slander Gene Haas because it's a completely legal thing to do. I'm just saying that this is my theory as to what he's doing.
It's an unsporting thing. If that is what he's doing, it is an unsporting thing to do.
Yeah.
And it is, you're wasting all of that possibility for millions and millions of fans around the world. And ruining the careers of drivers and engineers and well, maybe not the engineers, but
no,
because
they can always go on to somewhere
certainly
else.
The drivers.
Yeah, drivers have a very finite time. Anyway. Yeah. Hamo, you get to pick a song because
nobody's picked one.
Yeah.
Get in that song list, people.
Or Hamo can just pick songs.
What did I change?
I have no idea.
What did I change? Something.
You played songs last night.
Yeah, what did I do?
14 Days and Nights, something else. That
Love Ain't Blind.
Yeah, Love Ain't Blind. And then you did Ain't Nobody. And the crowd at the pub shocked me. I didn't think that they would all be singing along to some Chaka Khan, but they were down for it. When we win the lottery, we won't buy F1. We will let you buy F1, but we will go to every single race. Thank you, Orbiter. Orbiter has requested a song.
All right.
Great choice, by
Shotgun
the way.
While you're resting there.
Huh?
Shotgun.
Oh, okay. You're going to do that one first?
No.
Do that one after?
Yeah.
Okay. I will put that in. I will put that in. How's everybody's Wednesdays going? Or how was your Wednesday, if it's...
I have a question for Orby about pickups.
Oh, okay. I do what I want. So yeah, Orbiter, apparently Hamo has pickup questions. You gonna message him?
Who's gonna tell you when? No. It's too late. Gonna tell you things aren't so great. You can't go on thinking nothing's wrong. Drive you home tonight.
hold you down when you push. Who's gonna come around when you break? Can't go on thinking nothing's wrong. Oh no, yeah, you can't go on still thinking that nothing's wrong. No, no, who's gonna drive you home tonight? So tell me, who's gonna drive you home tonight? Tonight? Tonight?
Lovely.
I cannot get rid of this.
The fucking frog
shit
in your throat.
In my throat.
Exactly what Skeggy said. See, Barina, I mean, I am not a fan of just outright quitting a job and having no other job to go to, but if your job is making you ill, if you hate the work, if you hate the people, if you cannot envision joy ever again by having this job, it's time to find something else.
Yeah, go do something else.
Phoning in sick won't change the job that you don't like, is what Skeggy said, and he's exactly right. Life is far too short. You will regret not leaving sooner. Find yourself something
better. Better things are out there waiting for you to discover.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, I've had two jobs here that sucked.
The last one.
Yeah, the one before this one.
The interim job.
Yeah, the interim job.
And the first job.
No, the first one was fine.
Oh, TFL?
Yeah, TSL. That was horrible. That was a maternity contract, and I didn't like the person I worked for. I didn't like the other people there. I had a full-on panic attack coming out of the tube. I remember, well, it wasn't a panic attack. It was an anxiety attack. I'm like, I just can't go. I can't go. I don't want to be there. I don't like these people.
I remember
so
that.
That was,
you called me.
Yeah, I was in tears. A woman stopped on the street and asked if I was okay. I mean, I was, yeah. So don't do that to yourself. Don't allow yourself. I don't want to say allow yourself. That's not the right word, but don't let something like a job make you feel that way about yourself, because it's not good. It's not healthy. And yeah, obviously you got to have the money. So tough it out until, but I mean, look, just get out there and look. I'm also happy to help look at CVs. I'm very good at with CVs. So feel free to drop me a whisper. I'll send you my email address and I can help with CVs and all of that stuff. See, exactly. You were crying in the car on the way home yesterday. This is not healthy.
Yeah.
It's not good. Drop me a note. Let me know where you work, what you do, all of that stuff. I know people who know people who know people. I might be able to help. I can't guarantee I'll be able to help, but you never know. I might be able to help. But yeah, there is definitely something better out there. We just have to figure out what it is. Exactly. Orbiter says it. Open yourself up to new opportunities and they will come to you. And they might come in weird situations. You know, you might think, oh God, well, I I'd never even considered working, you know, as a lumberjack. But you know what?
I like the outdoors. Turns out I like the outdoors. Yeah. I like plaid.
Apparently being a lumberjack is cool as hell. You know, you just don't know. But I'm not saying be a lumberjack, but you know what I mean. But do know that you are more than your job as well.
Yeah.
So don't let them make you feel bad about yourself. You're a wonderful person. And you're not defined by your job and the people you work with. Orbiter said, turns out flannel suits me.
School beauty queen, eyes like you've never seen, hair like summer rain. He said, darling, come with me, I promise I will be your one and only everything. So she let him light the flame. Wasn't true, what would her parents say? Too young to be this way, so alone and so afraid. So she went to him to share, but when she told him, he turned to leave, saying, are you sure it's mine? 'Cause I don't believe. I suppose you think this change is everything. You ask me, but I can't say yes. Don't you see you're suffocating me with your shotgun and your wedding dress? Shotgun and a wedding dress. He was really going far, high school football star, a student with a car, and all the best they planned. She said, darling, you're the one, and now what's done is done, something we can't run from. I need you to be a man. But as she spoke the words, he turned to go, saying, this is all your fault, and just so you know. I suppose you think this change is everything. You ask me, but I can't say yes. Don't you see you're suffocating me with your shotgun and your wedding dress? Shotgun and a wedding dress. But once he saw how small and frail the child, he knew he'd have to stay and walk down the aisle. I suppose this really changes everything. I swear to try to give my best. So put away the dreams of old for new ones, along with your shotgun and your wedding dress.
along with your shotgun and your wedding dress. Along with your shotgun and your wedding dress. Along with your shotgun and your wedding dress. Shotgun and a wedding dress.
I like it better now.
Yeah, that you've
that added that bit.
Added that bit.
Added the sex bit in there.
Yeah.
And the second verse.
Yeah, this is the thing, Roy. Any employer, no matter how much they value you and how well you're treated, I mean, I'm treated well, Madam X is treated well, and it's good. So it makes your day-to-day easier. But if for some reason you couldn't work there anymore, they would miss you for a little bit, but obviously they're going to replace you. You know?
Yeah. The
Roy was like, you know, when it came to redundancies, I was only a number after 46 years in the same trade. You know, they are going to move on.
Here's the reality. The ugly reality. You are only...
Hello, Two Fantastic. Welcome in.
Two Fantastic. Welcome in. You are only worth the minimum amount that is required to keep you in your seat.
Yes.
Or replace you with somebody else.
Yeah. What is the minimum that you will do this task for?
They're obligated. Employers are obligated by a weird sense of obligation to provide raises, but there's no laws that say they have to give you a raise every year.
No.
And a lot of people work and don't get raises every year.
Mm-hmm.
And when they do get a raise, it's minimal.
Yeah.
So every year the cost of living on average goes up 7%,
something like that. It depends.
And the average cost of the average raise is 3%.
Mm.
So the first year, you're 4% less well off.
Yep.
The second year, it goes up another 7%, and you only get 3% on what you had last year.
Yeah, which was still
already
a deficit. Yeah.
Already a deficit. So that's why that gap, when they show these graphs, and the blue line is doing this, and
mm-hmm.
the red line, which is the cost of living, is doing that, that's why that gap is getting wider.
Yeah, exactly.
But anyway. The problem is that it's part of a self-fulfilling prophecy. It's the Walmart principle.
Yeah. We want cheap goods, quick.
If you want cheap, nice things, they have to be made overseas because it's too expensive to make them in your home country.
Mm-hmm. Well.
Unless you live in China.
Yes. I mean, basically, yes. But they could afford to make them here were the capitalist bastards that are the CEOs and the shareholders not, you know, pulling in $1 billion a year.
It's not just that. The cost of living. You could go and live in Bali and spend, you know, $150 a month.
Exactly.
To
live fantastic.
On. And you'd be quite happy to do so.
Yeah. Yeah.
But, you know,
mm-hmm.
have you seen the spiders in Bali?
Yeah, no thanks.
Cocker dropped it.
Where is it?
It's under my nuts.
Ah, good Lord.
Did I get it?
No, it's in the song list. It's in there, Sparkle.
What?
Changes.
It's there. It's right there.
Yeah.
It's right there.
Where's my head?
I'm gonna play it next. So if you're only worth what, if you're only worth whatever the minimum is to keep you in your seat, find a seat that you want to be in.
Yeah.
That you don't mind being in if they paid you half of what it is that they're going to pay you.
Do something you really love.
Do something you really love to do.
Good night, Madam X.
Good night, Madam X. Good night, good night.
Well, let's
I'm
get...
I'm sorry you have to sleep beside Mr. X.
No, with Mr. X beside you.
All right. Beside, yeah. Not inside.
Yeah. All right, guys. Here's our goal. We get Seeparina into the Red Bull seat. Oh, the song list is now blank for you. Oh, that's very odd. It's been glitchy, apparently. They've been doing upgrades and having issues with it, but yeah.
Waiting for, and my time was running wild. A million dead end streets, and every time I thought I got it made, it seemed the taste was not so sweet. So I turned myself to face me, but I never even caught a glimpse of how the others must see the faker. I'm much too fast to take that test. Changes turn and face the strange changes. Don't wanna be a richer man. Changes turn and face the strange changes. Just gonna have to be a different man. Time may change me, but I can't trace time. Watch the ripples change their size, but never leave the stream of warm impermanent sand. So the days, they float through my eyes, but still the days, they seem the same. And those children that you spit on as they try to change their worlds are immune to your consultation. They're quite aware of what they're going through. Changes turn and face the strange changes. Don't you tell them to grow up and out of it. Changes turn and face the strange changes. Where's your shame? You left us up to our necks in it. Time may change me, but you can't change time. Strange fascination fascinating me. Changes are taking the pace I'm going through. Changes turn and face the strange changes. Oh, look out, you rock and rollers. Changes turn and face the strange changes. Pretty soon now you're gonna get older. Time may change me, but I can't trace time. I said the time may change me, but I can't trace time.
Mario.
Mario.
So, Maria's lurking.
What?
She's lurking. She's trying to fix the dishwasher.
Mm.
Is there anything we can do? Can we help virtually? Can we diagnose things for you? And Sparkle, thank you for the itty bitty bowie bitties.
Itty bitty bowie bitties.
Thank you very much.
Itty bitty bowie bitties.
It was an itsy bitsy teeny weeny tiny bowie bitty keeny. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing there.
Clearly.
clearly. Thanks for your applause, you guys. Thanks for hanging out with us. Yes, I think so. No, they're rubber gloves that you used for your last craft project. That I'll go get the Tums. They're out there.
So, yeah, do things that you want to do. Don't worry about the money. The money will come.
Well, I mean, you got to worry a bit about the money. You got to have somewhere to live. You got to, you know.
Yes, but,
you got to have somewhere to live and somewhere to eat, something to eat, but yes. Things do somehow have a way of working themselves out. Surprisingly.
When we made half of what we make now, I don't remember being any better off or any happier.
No. Yeah.
I'm still as miserable as I was then.
Early days, had your first session with the osteo yesterday. Excellent. Excellent. Oh, dear. Oh, Maria, I'm sorry. Seems there's no hope for the dishwasher.
I'm seeing that.
Gonna wash up all the dishes. That is... I hate doing the dishes, and I hate doing the laundry. Those are the two.
Oh, we move like cage of tigers. We couldn't get closer than this. The way we walk, the way we talk, the way we stalk, the way we kiss. We slip through the streets while everyone sleeps. Get bigger and sleeker and wider and brighter. We glide and scratch and scream all night. Let's go and throw off the songs we know. See, you and me, all the years of no answer. I show you in spring, it's a treacherous thing we missed. You hiss the love cats. We missed you hiss the ba da da ba 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 da ba da ba 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 da ba da da ba 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 da ba da ba ba ba. You're so wonderful. Wonderfully, wonderfully pretty. Oh, I know that I'd do anything for you. We should have each other to tea, huh? We should have each other with cream. Then curl up by the fire and sleep for a while. It's the grooviest thing, it's the perfect dream. In the sea, you and me, all the years and no one heard. I'll show you in spring, it's a treacherous thing we missed. You hiss the love cats. We missed you hiss the love cats. We missed you hiss the love cats. We missed you hiss the ba da da ba 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 da ba da ba 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 da. So wonderfully, 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 wonderfully pretty. Oh, you know that I'd do anything for you. We should have each other to tea, huh? We should have each other with cream. And then curl up by the fire and sleep for a while. It's the grooviest thing, it's the perfect dream. Hand in hand is the only way to land, but always the right way round. I broke in little pieces like, hey, little nieces, how could we miss someone as dumb as this? We missed you, hiss the love cats. We missed you, hiss the love cats.
cats. Come on, let's go, laugh, 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 cats. So wonderfully pretty, laugh, 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 cats. Come on, let's go, laugh, 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 cats. So wonderfully pretty, laugh, 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 cats.
I'm glad Maria requested that one. I love that one.
Yeah.
It's so fun to sing.
Yeah.
Ruby.
Yeah. Random request. Yeah, I liked that emote a lot.
On the list?
Well, obviously. Yeah. The little drum dance guy is cute as hell. The little bouncy guy, totally cute. Love the emotes. Thanks, everyone, for your great emotes, for your claps, for hanging out. You guys are awesome. Yes, exactly, Sparkles. Patting the bot gently on the head, thanking it for its wonderful service.
Oh, that's how it goes. All right.
The romance is dead, 'cause there's so little else occupying my head. There is nothing I need except the function to breathe, but I'm not really fussed, doesn't matter to me. Tomorrow is canceled. Let the clocks be reset and the pendulums held. 'Cause there's nothing at all except the space in between. Finding out what you call and repeating your name. Joking with me, and you don't really see you with me. Could it be that you're joking with me, and you don't really see you with me?
what you're doing, doing to me.
Uh-huh, yeah,
yeah. Oh, Ruby, 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 Ruby.
Uh-huh, yeah.
Oh, Ruby, 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 Ruby.
Uh-huh, yeah.
It's something like that.
There you go.
It wasn't quite entirely right.
Yeah.
So it was mostly.
I liked it.
Sort of right.
I liked it.
Oh, I'm glad you did.
As I was sitting in the never ending traffic jam on the A2 this afternoon, I was listening to I Guess That's Why They Call It the Blues on Greatest Hits and singing along with gusto as the rain came down and the wind nearly blew the car sideways. Good heavens.
Wow.
Yes. I am tired of this weather. Thanks for your applause, everybody.
Yeah, what's the heat wave we were supposed to be having the next 3 weeks?
Yeah, I want me a heat wave. Yes, I forgot about it as well, too, Sparkle, even though I have a big note right here in front of me. Literally, like, you know, this far away in front of me. Says Dancing in the Dark for Sparkles, because we bumped it off on Friday. But I did remember. I just glanced up. I'm like, oh, yeah, big note. Put that in the queue. So. It is there for you.
Society howl. You can't clap me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my plow. Oh, back to the howling old owl in the woods, haunting the horny black toad. Oh, I finally decided my future lies beyond the yellow brick they'll shoot down your plane. It'll take you a couple of vodka and tonics to set you on your feet again. Maybe you'll get a replacement. There's plenty like me to be found. Mongrels who ain't got a penny, sniffing for tippets like you on the dogs of society howl. You can't let me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my plow. Oh, back to the howling old owl in the woods, haunting the horny black toad. Oh, I've finally decided my future lies beyond the yellow brick road. Of society howl. You can't let me in your penthouse. I'm going back to my plow. Oh, back to the howling old owl in the woods, haunting the horny black toad. Oh, I finally decided my future lies beyond the yellow brick road.
felt that was exceptionally good.
Yeah.
Extra
you did
good.
Very good with that one.
I was liking that more. I changed the key of it, I think.
Because
I've recharted it, clearly. Because I didn't recognize that chart. So I've recharted it. And I might have changed the key of it, I think.
Okay, cool. Thanks, you guys, for all your applause.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thanks for hanging out with
Thank
us.
Thank you very much.
We're rapidly coming to the end. Got one more space in the queue. Could probably do... Yeah, probably do one more song after this. Sparkle enjoyed that as well, too. She said she hadn't heard it in a while. Nicely done. It was, that was her random request. Great gosh, good to see you.
Great gosh.
It's good to have you here again.
How are you, my friend?
Yeah, the random requests have been coming up pretty good tonight. Bot's doing a good job.
You're welcome.
Get up in the evening and I ain't got nothing to say. Come home in the morning, go to bed feeling the same way. I ain't nothing but tired. Oh man, I'm just tired and bored with myself. Hey there, baby, could use just a little help. You can't start a fire. You can't start a fire without a spark. This gun's for hire. Even if we're just dancing in the dark, messages keep getting clearer. Radio's on and I'm moving around the place. I check my look in the mirror. I wanna change my clothes, my hair, my face. Somewhere, oh baby, I just know that there is. You can't start a fire. You can't start a fire without a spark. This gun's for hire. Even if we're just dancing in the dark. Shoulders, come on, baby. This life's on me. Stay on the streets of this town, and they'll be carving you up, alright. They say you gotta stay hungry. Hey, baby, I'm just about starving tonight. Time for some action. Sick of sitting around being trying to write this book. I need a love reaction. Come now, baby. Give me just one look. You can't start a fire. Sitting around crying over a broken heart. This gun's for hire. Even if we're just dancing in the dark. You can't start a fire with that word about your world falling apart. This gun's for hire. Even if we're just dancing in the dark. Even if we're just dancing in the dark. Even if we're just dancing in the dark. Even if we're just dancing in the dark.
Croker's here. Good to see you, Croker. If you haven't followed Croker yet, do give Croker a follow.
That's it. Croker.
And Croker says, I swear I notice something different behind you every time I come in. There is a lot going on back
there's
here.
There's a lot of stuff back there.
Lot of stuff.
There's a lot of
detail. I mean, there's the Beatles men up there. There's concert ticket stubs. Hammo poster behind.
Lamp of Justice.
The Lamp of Justice.
Which is that one.
The Lamp of Justice sees.
There are two albums. One, yes. one here.
Behind
one,
the lamp.
One over there.
Oh, yeah.
Behind the other lamp. On the side of those bookcases. They're both Hammond albums.
They are.
I think one's this Hammond one's Fever.
And this one's Help Yourself to Hammond. Yeah. I'm guessing by the mugshot you're thinking this one up here. If that is what you're asking, that is a picture that a friend of ours drew for me for my birthday. It is Hugh Laurie in House. I don't know if you ever saw
from
the show.
From the show.
Yeah. I don't know if you ever saw the show House, but that would be Hugh Laurie. The guy who played Dr. House. Yeah, I was quite chuffed with it, actually. It's a very good likeness. He did well with that. But yeah, there's the fez up there next to it, and under the fez there is a mask of Darth Vader. Just a cheap knockoff one. Yeah, there's loads of stuff going on back there. You guys, this is it. We've hit the end. We've made it another awesome stream, each and every one of you. I'm going to run some credits. I'm going to find somebody to raid. And then we're going to say thank yous. Because you guys are the awesomest.
I understand that every life must end. And as we sit alone, I know someday we must go. Yeah, I'm a lucky man to count on both hands the ones I love. Some folks have just one, yeah. Others, they got none. Stay with me. Let's just breathe. Practiced all my sins, never gonna let me win. And under everything, just another human being. Yeah, I don't wanna hurt. There's so much in this world to make me bleed. Stay with me, you're all I see. Did I say that I need you? Oh, did I say that I want you? Oh, if I didn't, I'm a fool, you see. No one knows this more than me. As I come clean, I wonder every day as I look upon your face.
sun. And everything you gave and nothing you would take, oh no. Wednesday.
That is Wednesday. Y'all, thank you for hanging out with us.
Thank you.
We
thank
really
everybody.
Appreciate each and every one of you taking time.
We do. We
spend
say it,
time
we say it
with
every
us.
Week. Say it every show.
And mean
but,
it.
But it. But it is true. It is.
Y'all got busy lives. You got things that you could be doing.
Well, I don't know that they do, actually, because I keep tuning into this.
So the fact.
But we appreciate the fact that you have no life.
That you take time out of your day to come hang out with us, it means everything. So we really do appreciate it.
We do.
We are going to go raid out. We are going to go see Bole Heavy Rock because it's his birthday.
Oh, yeah. Let's do that.
So if you can come with us
birthday
with the raid, that would be great. And just wish him a quick happy birthday. If you have to raid and run, we totally get it if you can't hang with us. But I'm sure he would be stoked to get your birthday wishes.
He's a metal dude.
He is a metal dude. And yeah, we will see you all on Friday.
Be well, be safe, and, you know, behave yourselves as much as you can. And we'll see you Friday. Cheers, everybody. Bye.